Hi, everybody. This is Jennifer with Choice Slides. And I had a question come to me this morning about turning existing slide styles that maybe you imported from other third-party vendors, or maybe they came with ProShow but didn't import correctly, and you just want to turn them into Photopia native slide styles. You can do this. This is director only. And this is just an example. I have in the essentials list from ProShow, these backdrop, dark frame, zoom out 3D, and then there's light versions. These were some of my favorites, my go-tos back in ProShow. But the vignette, for whatever reason, does not get translated appropriately. So I'm going to fix this and then resave it. So again, you can do this with either, you know, original ProShow files or maybe a file that you imported from another third-party vendor. The first step is to apply it to a slide. I'm going to do that. So since these are being applied as existing slide styles, there's very little that you're going to have to do, especially if they already work correctly, because the layers will already be set appropriately. So in my layers list, if I look at this image, it's already set as a replaceable layer because this was a slide style. Now I can update this for Photopia in a couple of different ways. So in this case, it has a separate drop shadow layer. I can get rid of that because that's not necessary in Photopia. I can just delete this layer, then come into the top image, come into adjustments, and add my shadow. And the one thing that ProShow couldn't really do was kind of increase and animate the shadow better than just basic. So there's the shadow. That releases one layer, so that makes it a little less complicated. So that's one thing you can do to make this more Photopia friendly. The other thing that I would highly recommend is in the content tab, name this layer, and this is simply just going to be something like your image. Because the way Photopia works, if you apply a slide style and it has multiple duplicates of that, it can get confusing in the layers list, but the content will only show you the one layer you need to drag and drop. So rename the layer in the content tab. And then the other thing I need to do, as I mentioned, the outline is kind of messed up on this. So I'm going to select the top layer that has the vignette. I'll come into my adjustments tab. I'm going to turn off that vignette and add an outline instead, because that was what ProShow was trying to do. It was trying to make an outline, but it just didn't succeed very well. And then I'll just bring this up to whatever level I want. And there's my slide style that looks almost identical to the ProShow one, but it has now been updated both to fix something that didn't get translated well. I've removed a layer that Photopia doesn't need, and I've renamed the image in the content tab because this is where you'll probably add your image once it's applied to a slide style. So once I have made this exactly the way I want, in order to turn this into a slide style, you'll right click on that slide, choose create style, simply name this. And if you can't remember what it was called, it's whatever you've applied is right up here. This is backdrop, dark framed, zoom out 3D. And if you'd like to add a description, you can. If you want to change the author to remind yourself that maybe this came from Photodex, you could also change all of that. And then just hit OK. In Director, this will launch a separate window that kind of looks like your regular slides show window, but it's not. This only has one slide. This is your slide style window. And again, you don't have to do much here because this, since you started with an existing slide style, the layers are already set as replaceable. So there's not much to do here. Now the variant, this you would only really have to mess with if you needed to change the animation to work with tall or wide. We don't really have to do that, and I'll show you how you can double check. I'm going to select this, choose add variant, copy current, so this is identical. Now for the second one, I'm going to drop in a tall image instead of wide. And it still looks just fine. So I don't need a variant. This variants are really only needed if you need to make adjustments depending on whether you're dropping in a tall or wide image. These look exactly the same. I don't need to change a thing. So I actually don't need this second variant. So I'm going to delete that. So in the variant for this, I'm just going to leave all of these checked, landscape, portrait, square, because this works with all of them. If I needed a second one, and I had to change the way the animation looked depending on the orientation, I would come back, maybe take portrait off of this one, and then take landscape off of the second one, then it would recognize your image orientation. Again, I don't need to do that for this one. So the last thing you need to do, come up to the Style Settings tab, and you'll just want to add these into whatever category you want. I will put this back into the Essentials because that's where it was. This probably will not overwrite the original, by the way, because this isn't exactly the same thing. The other one was imported. This one will come from your projects. Also, this one has different details because I didn't change it to Photodex. So if you're wanting to name it exactly the same and you think it's going to overwrite it, it will not because it's actually not identical. So I'm going to save this. This is my new backdrop dark frame zoom out 3D. I can just close this window, by the way. I have, when you open up that second window to create your slide style, you actually have two Photopia windows open. So I'll close that. Then I can come into my Manage Effects window and come to my Essentials and look for the backdrop dark frame zoom out 3D. And you can see I now have two of them. So, and this is the one I just made. You can tell by looking at the thumbnail. This is the original. And if you look at the information, this is how you can tell them apart. This one is the copyrighted Photodex. It was imported third party effects. This one doesn't have any information because I didn't enter any. It also says it's mine and it's located in my projects, not third-party effects. So there are two of them. If you want to get rid of your original, just select this and hit remove, and that will get rid of your original, and then you'll only have the one that you built. So it's a little bit complicated, but that's how you can kind of update either old pro show styles, either to make them work with, you know, multiple variants if you want to do that, or if they need updating like this one did because the outline wasn't working. Or if you have, you know, maybe a third party style that you really just want to be Photopia generated and either, you know, add variants or fix it. This is how you would do that. You can update transitions, but if you think this was complicated, updating transitions is 10 times more complicated because you cannot create a transition from a transition. So that's more complicated. I won't be getting that into that in this tutorial. This was just how to take an existing slide style that you imported and turn it into a Photopia generated slide style. Thank you so much for watching and for allowing me to help you unleash your creativity.